Good morning students. Today we are going to discuss about module number 3, that is performance of transmission lines. Here we are going to discuss about the effect of load power factor on regulation and efficiency. So effect of load power factor on regulation and efficiency. So the regulation and efficiency of a transmission line depends on a considerable extent upon the power factor of the load, because if the load is dealing with the excited power supply, by the time the load is more than that of the rated load, automatically it draws that more amount of current. Actually, we can operate with lagging power factor. So during that interval, it is not possible to increase the line voltage, because as to meet that highest power factor as 1, there is a need of regulation. So in order to know about that, the performance of a given transmission line, that is short transmission lines, here we are going to discuss about that regulation and efficiency of the transmission line. So the regulation and efficiency of the transmission line again depends upon the power factor. So effect on regulation, the expression for voltage regulation for a short transmission line, which is given by percentage of voltage regulation, that is equal sending end voltage minus receiving end voltage to the receiving end voltage into 100. This is the general formula what we are using to find out that voltage regulation for any load what it is going to deal. Then percentage of voltage regulation, we can write the formula of Vs minus Vr, that is difference between sending end voltage to receiving end voltage. Here we can write that Ir into cos pi r plus Ixl into sin pi r divided by Vr into 100. So this is the equation what we are taken into count from the concept of performance of short transmission lines. Then again we can write, this is the formula what here we are expressed for percentage of voltage regulation for lagging power factor. We can also express the same formula, that is percentage of voltage regulation for leading power factor. If I am going to express the topic, that is percentage of voltage regulation for leading power factor, the same formula here I can express, that is IR into cos pi r minus I into XL into sin pi r divided by VR. For leading power factor, here we can see that it is expressed with minus sign it here. For lagging power factor, it is expressed with plus sign here. That means this is IR into cos pi r, I into R into cos pi r, that is nothing but IR is nothing but voltage. So V into cos pi r, that is already existing voltage, plus another voltage I into XL, that is sin pi. So cos pi represents that real power and sin pi represents that reactive power. So already existing real voltage, I am going to add one more voltage called that reactive voltage to the existing real voltage in order to improve the lagging power factor. So that's why here we can express as positive sign. So this kind of positive sign we can take in the percentage of voltage regulation, where we are exchanging that real voltage, where we are exchanging that reactive voltage to the real voltage in order to improve the power factor. This is the case where we are writing the formula for percentage of voltage regulation at the case of under voltage problem. But in the case of over voltage problem, where we want to bring that over voltage to rated voltage or within the specified limits, that means where we have to absorb the reactive voltage, here we are injecting the reactive voltage, that's why it is represented with the plus sign. So plus I into XL of sin pi r. Here we are absorbing the reactive voltage from existing already existing voltage, that is IR into cos pi r minus IXL into sin pi r divided by VR. So this is the case where we are discussing about to bring that over voltage to rated voltage. By that time here we can express it as minus IXL into sin pi r. So reactive voltage is expressed with minus sign here for leading power factor. So to bring that leading power factor into unity power factor, the reactive voltage as expressed as negative sign here, the reactive voltage is expressed as positive sign at here. Next, effect on transmission efficiency. There is a effect on transmission efficiency because we are transferring the electrical power from sending end to receiving end side. So according to the demand of the load, we are transferring that electrical power up to the rated value of the conductor. While power is delivered to the load depends upon the power factor. That means power factor cos phi is equal, that means 1, that is highest power factor. If cos phi is less than 1, that is that lagging power factor. If cos phi value which is greater than 1, that is expressed as leading power factor. But most of the cases our loads are inductive loads, we are suffered with lagging power factor. For suppose we know that power delivered on the transmission line, we know the formula, that is P is equal VI cos phi. So here sending end side power formula we can write as VR into I into cos of pi R, where pi R is nothing but phase angle between that receiving end voltage and its current for single phase line. So for single phase transmission line, the flow of current through the conductor, we can express the formula after simplifying from here. That is, here I want to know that current I. Therefore, I is equal P divided by VR into cos pi R. This is the formula what we can write directly to know the single phase transmission line current. Next. Similarly, however, we define the formula for power in case of single phase transmission line and for the current. Similarly, we can also express the formula for power for three-phase transmission line. For three-phase transmission line, with respect to three conductors, I am going to multiply with an integer 3 for the above existing formula of single-phase transmission line. Therefore, P is equal 3VR I cos pi R. Here also, pi R is nothing but phase angle between receiving end voltage and its current. So, in case of three-phase transmission line, the flow of current I formula, I is equal capital P divided by 3VR into cos of pi R. So from the above expressions, I mean from that concept of like percentage of voltage regulation for lagging power factor and for leading power factor, and from the effect of transmission efficiency either for single phase transmission line power formula and for its currents, and for three phase power transmission line and its power and power formula and for its current formula, it is clear that in each case, for a given amount of power to be transmitted and the receiving end voltage here, it is VR, because if you see here, the transferring power is mathematically expressed as P and the receiving end voltage which is expressed as VR. Therefore, it is clear that in each case, for a given amount of power which is transmitted, that is power P which is transmitted, and receiving end voltage which is expressed as capital V suffix R, the load current I is inversely proportional to the load power factor cos pi R. Because if you see that earlier equations here, the load current either for single phase transmission line or for three phase transmission line, if you see that the load current I is inversely proportional to the power factor, and I is directly proportional to the flow of power either for single phase transmission line or for three phase transmission line. Here current is inversely proportional to cos of pi r, power factor, and it is directly proportional to its rate of transfer of power P. Therefore, the load current I is inversely proportional to the load power factor called cos pi suffix r. Consequently, with the decrease in the load power factor, if there is a decrease in the load power factor, the load current and hence the line losses are increases, because there is a relation between current and power factor that is inversely proportional. If power factor is decreasing, then current is increasing. Not only the flow of current is increases, but also its losses are also going to increases. Therefore, from these analysis here, we can say that power factor plays a major role to define that performance of a transmission lines like short transmission lines. If you look about that performance of a short transmission line, that depends upon the percentage of voltage regulation, where voltage regulation we can increase it for lagging power factor as by adding that reactive voltage to the existing voltage, and by subtracting that reactive voltage to the existing voltage, where we can control the leading power factor to its rated power factor. Like that, here we can increase that performance of the transmission line, and here by reducing the power factor, we can increase that flow of current. That means current and power factor both are inversely proportional relation at here. So transmission efficiency of line losses with the decrease in load power factor and its vice versa. Thank you.